Yo, what is up, guys? It's your boy Bernie here. Just kind of wanted to talk about this Marcus Smart situation. I know that it's been causing a lot of turmoil for the Celtics fans and what's been going on. And I do apologize that I'm not in my normal studio. Obviously, I'm out at the gym. You know, I have open gym tonight as well for my basketball team. So obviously, I won't be live streaming tonight, but we will be live streaming. I'm going to hopefully Friday for sure. Friday, I believe the 5th, we're live streaming 110,000%. My boy Pete will be there. But in terms of tomorrow, I'm not so sure. Be on the lookout, and I'll also put a YouTube short letting you know that we will be live streaming. But nevertheless, I did want to talk about this Marcus Smart situation. He publicly called out his teammates Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown, the Jays, if you will. I know Tyrese likes to call them the Jays. I'm not sure where the nickname comes from, but that's kind of what it is right now. But nevertheless, I do think the frustrating part about this whole situation right now for the Boston Celtics is the fact that right now we are just spineless as an organization, as a unit. I went on a huge rant yesterday, a passionate one, because I really feel strongly that this team is not built for success of really getting us over the hump, getting us to a situation where, hey, you know, maybe we could be in the playoffs and maybe do some damage. You know, we've been in the multiple times. The Eastern Conference Finals in the bubble, Eastern Conference Finals with Terry Rozier, and, you know, the year Kyrie Irving got hurt, and it was Jason Tatum's rookie year. And I just feel like right now, the frustration for me is that guys like Jason Tatum, and really more so Jason Tatum, I understand that Kobe was your idol. I understand Kobe, you know, the Mamba mentality. I get all that. But the problem is the fact that, you know, you shot 1-for-8 in that fourth quarter against the Chicago Bulls, and that is unacceptable. Right now, this is probably Jason Tatum's worst start of his career, maybe even since his rookie year. I even think he was better in his rookie year than he is now. And I just think that he needs to kind of learn within himself, like, look, I can't play like, I'm not going to be Kobe Bryant. And I just feel like there's a lot of times where Jason Tatum does head-scratching moves. I remember in the bubble, you know, taking this weird sidestep three instead of, you know, making a good shot, you know, to win the game, especially that was like the deciding game that could have actually won us the chance to go against the Lakers in the NBA Finals. And instead, it kind of led to a situation where we're at right now, where I just don't know where this team honestly goes. I understand Marcus Smart shouldn't have said it publicly. I understand Marcus Smart shouldn't have really called him out publicly, but I just feel like everyone's talked about it already, you know, whether it's Undisputed or First Take. So I'm not trying to claim this take as my own. But you already know that those guys have been talking to each other nonstop. You know, Marcus Smart isn't a guy that's going to hold it within himself and be like, well, I don't want to say anything because I don't want to seem rude. I don't want to seem like an a-hole. But at the end of the day, look, you're taking way too many shots. You're not helping the organization. You're not doing anything like that. And that's not going to help anybody right now. No one's being helped right now with the way that Jason Tatum has been playing. And I have to put the blame on Jason Tatum because I feel like Jaylen Brown has actually played okay. He has been at times a little bit out of control, but at the end of the day, I really do think that this all rests on the shoulders and broad shoulders of Jason Tatum. You know, I looked at the workout videos. I was like, yes, this is going to be the year where Jason Tatum absolutely goes off. He's going to go crazy for us. He's going to be the Boston Celtics that we know and love. He's going to be the number one guy. But right now, I don't even know if he's the number one guy in the Boston Celtics. I know that's blasphemous to say. I know that's hyperbole. And people can say, like, you're going crazy after just 1 week. But the problem is that when I see Jason Tatum's game, it doesn't speak to me as a game where I'm like, you know what? I'm confident this guy can take us to the next level and take us anywhere. You know, his passing ability has been frustrating, to say the least. I know he's not the best passer in the world, but I would love him to at least, you know, dish the rock out a little bit more than he is. You know, he does it kind of like out of last second resort and all that stuff. So, you know, it's not really one of those situations. I look at it and I'm like, you know, Jason Tatum, it's time to kind of see the things at hand, right? It's time to understand, like, look, you cannot be the guy that does these, like, Kobe Bryant-esque moves on, like, three defenders. You know, I think Shannon Sharpe said it best, and I just watched his little usurp, and that's what kind of inspired me to kind of put out this video before Wednesday or Friday, is because I feel like Jason Tatum wants to emulate Kobe Bryant so bad, live up to the legacy of the Black Mamba and all this stuff. But the problem is, I want Jason Tatum to be Jason Tatum. I don't want him to be a Kobe Bryant clone. Like, he should be his own man. And I hope that he understands that, like, no one's really trying to insult him or insult, like, his game or anything like that. What we are trying to do is say, look, you don't have to be Kobe Bryant. You can be Jason Tatum. You can be a guy that is really you know, the best moves is, you know, kind of like the shimmy-yay and attack the rim that way. I just feel like the sidesteps and anything that has to do with some, either like a sidestep or a, you know, kind of like a between the legs step back, like any of that stuff, I just feel like that's not Jason Tatum's strong suit. And I feel like if he could learn to be more stationary with his jump shot in terms of doesn't need to be on the move to create the jumper to do anything like that, I honestly think he would be a much better player. But at the end of the day, we'll see what happens. It's going to be one of those situations. We look at it, we see what's going on, and it's going to be a thing where I'm just not sure what's going to be the right thing for I would say I'm not sure what's going to be the right thing for the Boston Celtics at this point. I would love for the Boston Celtics to either move on or do something where they can, you know, get better. But at the end of the day, we're looking at a situation where I'm just not sure what really is Boston's moves, because, you know, I'm talking to my friend Brad, who's like, oh, well, you need to give Romeo Langford a chance and let him develop in the NBA. The problem is like, we have given him chances. And I think we have done a fairly decent job. I know he's been hurt, and that's kind of been the big thing about Romeo Langford. But at the end of the day, we have given him chances. Naismith, we've obviously given him chances. It's like we've given these young guys a chance. We just need a lot more veteran leadership in that locker room. You know, it can't just be Marcus Smart and Al Horford. You know, Al Horford isn't the most outspoken guy. He's more of a quiet, keep to himself type of guy. It isn't really going to cause much of a fuss like Marcus Smart would. And the problem with Marcus Smart, and I talked about it in the last stream, is that like he has no room to talk when he's shooting 28% from the floor, both three and field goal percentage. And it's like, as much as I would love to back him like 1,000% on what he said, it's also one of those things I often just have to look at it and say, look, the problem is that when you're shooting 28% from the floor, yeah, I wouldn't pass to you either, because you're obviously not going to be a bucket. It's a 28% chance you'll make the shot, and that just can't be the formula for the Celtics' success to win a championship, to actually do something in the NBA. And instead, what we're hearing now, what we're seeing, is that the Celtics are basically stuck with these players until the Jays leave. Like, I think one of them is probably going to leave now at this point. You know, I was like, nah, you know, Tyrese, when Tyrese was on the show talking about it, I was like, nah, Tyrese, you're kind of crazy, man. There's no way that they would give up, you know, those two guys. There's no way that those two guys would leave Boston. But at the end of the day, like, I don't blame them if they would leave Boston, because look, right now the Celtics are not competing for anything. They're not going to contend for a championship. They're not going to really do anything crazy in the postseason. They're basically just going to be bog standard, either play-in type players or sixth seed. And when you're dealing with the sixth through eighth seed, it really can be go up and down. It can go either way, right? It could go like really well for us, or it could go really bad. And I just think that's going to go horribly wrong for us. And like I said in the chat, when I was premiering the Celtics video from last night and put it out this morning at 11 a.m., go and check it out if you haven't checked it out. I really was like, you know, are we going to be in the lottery this year in terms of, are we going to be like a top five pick? And that's not where the Celtics that I'm used to seeing be in that situation. Like, yes, they got it through trading. They got it through all this stuff. And you know, we kind of live off the legacy of those trades, right? We got Jaylen Brown. We got Jason Tatum. I understand that. But we also did a lot of misses in that draft, right? Naismith is a big miss. Romeo Langford, a big miss. And there's just a bunch of other players as well that were big misses in that draft. You know, Robert Williams, you know, not really in that, you know, top pick. But I think right now the Boston Celtics are looking at a situation where we just need to start coming up with a game plan for the next couple of years. Because like I said, the reason why I'm upset is because we didn't get the point guard that I thought we should have gotten in Lonzo Ball. We didn't get any big man. I would love Sabonis. Any Sabonis would be good for me. I think even Karl-Anthony Towns, you know, I feel like he could have been a guy that we could have gotten as well. You know, low market, could have seen if we could have absolutely got him. But at the end of the day, it is what it is. But again, I want to kind of preface this by saying I hope you guys are doing, if you're Boston Celtics fans, I hope you guys are, you know, not taking it too seriously right now like I am. And hopefully you guys are kind of chilling on the Boston Celtics and not really having high expectations for them this year. Not saying that they won't, you know, those guys won't be all-stars, but it's really hard to root for those guys when it doesn't seem like they're playing like a team right now. It seems like it's Jason Tatum, it's Jaylen Brown, it's Marcus Smart, it's Robert Williams, and there's no real cohesion, there's no real unity when it comes to those guys. But let me know in the comment section down below, do you guys think I'm right or wrong in this situation? I would love to to hear what you guys have to say in the comment section about Marcus Smart's comments saying that those two guys shoot too much. And what do you guys make of the whole Boston Celtics situation right now with the guys that we have and we re-signed them, and, you know, kind of what the next step is for the Boston Celtics. Anyway, guys, like I said, my name is Bernie. Thank you once again for joining me here on The Charge. Again, a different type of video, not my studio in the car, but I wanted to talk about this because I thought it was very important. But anyway, guys, like I said, please remember to hit that like, share, and subscribe and get us to 1,000 subscribers. Anyway, guys, I'll catch you later. Peace out, everybody.